Hi friends, welcome you back to the video. Today we are going to learn a new lesson on triangles. This is something which we have already learned in your earlier classes. In 98th standard you have studied about triangles, you know different types of triangles, etc. We are going to further increase our knowledge about these triangles. Now, the first thing that we have to learn here is that in a triangle, if I draw a line, a straight line, parallel to one of the sides, let me take this as ABC. Now BC is one of the sides of the triangle. What I have done is I have drawn a line parallel to BC. DE is parallel to BC. Parallel to BC, and it cuts the sides AB and AC at the points D and E respectively, as I have indicated in the figure. So these two sides are parallel to each other. DE and BC is parallel to each other. Now, what this basic proportionality theorem states is that if in a triangle we draw a line parallel to one of the sides, then the line so drawn will cut the other two sides in the same ratio or in the same proportion. Right? This theorem is called as the basic proportionality theorem, or it is shortly called as BPT. Proportionality theorem, or BPT, we call this as BPT. Now, I have taken a triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. Now, we have to prove. What we have to prove is, AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. This is what is to be proved. Now, AE by EC. Now, what I do is, I will do some construction. I will join BE and DC. BE and DC. Now, from E, I will draw a perpendicular to AB. I will call this as N, EN. Similarly, I will draw a perpendicular to AE from D. I will call this point as M. Now, area of triangle ADE, area of triangle ADE is, you know, half base. Area of a triangle is half base. Base is AD. I will take once AD as the base. AD, if I take the base, the altitude is EN, half AD into EN. Now, it can also be written as area of triangle ADE can also be given as half into, if I take AE as the base, AE into DM. This way also I can give. Now, area of triangle BDE is half BD into EN. Similarly, area of triangle DEC is half base, that is, I'll take EC as the base. If I take EC as the base, the altitude is dm, AC into dm. Right. Now, dividing these two, this and this, this and this, what do I get? Area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE, I get half AD into AN, AD into EN divided by half BD into EN. Now this half gets cancelled, EN gets cancelled, so I get AD by BD. Right. Similarly, dividing area of ADE, area of triangle ADE by area of triangle DEC, I get half AE into DM. Here I'll take this AE into DM divided by half EC into DM. Now here half gets cancelled, DM gets cancelled, so AE by EC I get. Now triangle DEB and triangle DCE are on the same base DE and between the same parallels DE and BC, right? Therefore, area of triangle BDE must be equal to area of triangle DCE. So therefore AD by BD is equal to AE by EC. This is what we have to prove, that this straight line EDE divides these two sides AB and AC in the same ratio in the same ratio if it is parallel to BC. This is what we have to prove, and we have proved that. Hello friends. Now we have proved this. Now the converse of this is also true. Converse. Now what do you mean by converse of a theorem is? The converse is, can be stated like this. If a line cuts two sides of a triangle in same ratio, then that line should be parallel to the third side of the triangle. This is called as the converse. What we have proved earlier is that if we draw a line parallel to one of the sides of a triangle, it cuts the other two sides in the same ratio. This is what we proved. Now the converse will be, the reverse of that will be, it can also be proved that if two sides of a triangle are cut by a straight line in the same ratio or proportion, then that line should be parallel to the third side of the triangle. This is what we call converse. That can also be proved. Okay. Then we will take up the other properties of the triangles. After the basic proportionality theorem, we have to know about similar triangles. We have to know similar triangles. Now, you have already studied in 9th standard about congruent triangles. Congruent triangles. When two triangles have same shape and same size also, both shape and size, then we say they are congruent, and it is written like this. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR or whatever it is. You write like this. This is called as congruent. If you write like this, it means that triangle ABC and triangle PQR, two different triangles, are congruent to each other. Congruent means, congruency or congruent means that ABC and PQR are having same shape as well as same size. If they are of same shape but not of same size, then they are said to be similar. If they are similar, what we do is we write triangle ABC or any triangle like this is similar to triangle DEF or whatever it is, like this. This is the symbol used for similarity. So two congruent triangles may be similar to each other, but two similar triangles need not be congruent. You always remember that. Now here, on what basis we will decide the similarity? Now if I have two triangles, if I have two triangles LMN and PQR, if angle M is X, angle Q is also X, angle M is Y degrees, this is also Y degrees, this is Z degrees, and this is also Z degrees. Here, three angles of this triangle are equal to the three angles, corresponding angles of the other triangle, then we say that these two can be said to be similar to each other. We write triangle LMN is similar to triangle PQR. PQR. Then what happens is, if this is called AAA criterion. AAA criterion means angle criterion, or it can also be told as AA criterion also, we can say, because if two angles of a triangle are equal to the two corresponding angles of the other triangle, the third angle will be automatically it will be equal, because the sum of the three angles of a triangle must be equal to 180 degrees. Hence, so we can call this as AAA property or AA property. If the two triangles are similar, then what happens is the ratio of these sides, that is LM by PQ, corresponding sides, LM and PQ is equal to, the ratio of LM by PQ will be equal to ratio of MN to QR is equal to LN by PR, right. The ratio of the corresponding sides will be equal if two triangles are similar on the criterion of similarity of equality of angles of the triangle. So this is one property of similar triangles. Similarly, the two triangles may be similar if their sides are proportional, that is called SSS property. Side property, That is the reverse of what I said just now. If LM by PQ is equal to MN by QR is equal to LN by PR, then the three angles will be equal, the three corresponding angles will be equal, and the two triangles will be similar. So it is called side similarity criterion. Similarity criterion. You are supposed to remember this. Then another criterion, another basis on which we can call two triangles as similar is if one angle of the triangle is equal to the other angle of the corresponding angle of the triangle, and the ratio of the sides which include that angle are proportional, then we can say that these two are similar. Now that criterion is called as SAS criterion. So these are the three criterions. One is AAA, or you can also call it as AA. And second is SSS, and the third is SAS. These are the three criterion on which we can decide the similarity of the triangles. The next property of the similar triangles we should be aware of is that the areas of any two similar triangles, the ratio of areas of the two similar triangles is equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides. This is another theorem which can be proved. That is, the ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to the ratio of squares of their corresponding sides. Now, let us take two similar triangles. Let us say we have two triangles which are similar. It is known, it is given that these two triangles are similar. These two triangles are similar. Similar. One is ABC. ABC is one triangle. PQR is the other triangle. These two are similar to each other. Now, it is given. Given is triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Now, what we have got to prove is area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB square by PQ square is equal to BC square by QR square is equal to BAC square or CA square by PR square. This is what we have to prove. This is to be proved according to this theorem. Now what I will do is, let us say we drop the perpendicular here. This is, I will call this as AM, and I will draw another perpendicular from here. This is PN. So I have drawn, construction to be done is draw AM perpendicular, draw AM perpendicular to BC in triangle ABC, and PN perpendicular to QR in triangle PQR. Perpendicular to QR. Now we know that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to half base, that is BC, into altitude, that is AM, divided by half into QR into PM. Half base into altitude, this gets cut. So BC into AM by QR into PM. Now what I do is, let us take the triangles ABC and in triangle ABC, ABM, and let us take PQN. We know that angle B is equal to angle Q. It is given because ABC is similar to PQR, means the B is equal to Q. Then AMB, triangle angle AMB, is equal to angle PNQ, both are 90 degrees because they are perpendicular. We have taken them to be perpendicular to BC, and AM is perpendicular to BC and PN is perpendicular to QR, so they are 90 degrees. So these angles are equal. Now naturally this angle must be equal to this angle because the sum of the three angles must be 180 degrees. So therefore triangle ABM is similar to triangle PQN on AA criterion, angle criterion. So this is known. Now therefore what happens is, AB by PQ is equal to AM by PN is equal to BM by QR. Now let us call this as 1 and this as 2. Now AM by PN, here AM divided by PN can also be written as AB by PQ, we can write it, and BC by QR is also equal to, because ABC is similar to PQN. Now what I can do is, so area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR will be equal to, instead of BC by QR, I can write it as AB by PQ, because AB by PQ into AM by PN is also equal to AB by PQ, that is AB square by PQ square. Similarly, we can also prove that this ratio is equal to, it is equal to BC square by QR square is equal to AC square by PR square. So this is the theorem that I have stated here. So it can be proved like this. Next, let us take up the proof of Pythagoras theorem, a very famous theorem called Pythagoras theorem. You are aware of this theorem. I think you have used this theorem in the earlier classes also. It states that in any right angle triangle, right angled triangle, the square on the hypotenuse, is equal to the sum of the squares, on the other two sides. This is the statement of the Pythagoras theorem. Now, what it means is, let us say we have a right angle triangle. This is a right angle triangle. This is A, this is B, this is C. Here it is a right angle. ABC. ABC is a, this is, we know, is a right angle triangle. A triangle in which angle B is 90 degrees. Now, the side opposite to this right angle, that is AC, is the longest side in the triangle, because this is the largest angle in the triangle. So the side opposite to the largest angle will be the largest side. So AC is called as the hypotenuse. And the other two sides are AB and BC. So what we have to prove is, we got to prove that AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. This is what we have to prove. Now, what I will do is, I will draw a perpendicular from B to cut AC at D. Now, this angle is 90 degrees. Now, triangle ABD is similar to triangle ABC because angle A is common, angle A is equal to angle A, and angle ADB is equal to angle ABC, that is both are equal to 90 degrees. So due to this, two angles of this AA criterion, because of the AA criterion, triangle ABD is equal to triangle. So what will happen is, AB by AD is equal to BC by AB, or cross multiplying, AB square is equal to AD into BC, right? Call this as 1. Now, similarly, we can say that triangle ADC is also similar to triangle ABC, again on AA criteria, angle-angle criterion. We can say that these two are this thing. Now, therefore, BC by DC will be equal to BD by BC, correct? Or BC square will be equal to BD into DC. Now, BD into DC. Now we'll call that as 2. This should not be, I think this should be AC. AC, not BD. So this will be AC into DC, right? This will be AC into DC. Now adding 1 and 2, adding equation 1 and 2, what we get is AB square plus BC square is equal to AD into BC plus AC into DC. AC into DC. So AB square plus BC square is equal to, here the common factor is AC. This is also AC. This is AC. Here it was AC. This should be AC into BC. AC into BC. The common factor is AC into AD plus DC. AD plus DC. AD plus DC is nothing but AC, C into AC, that is AC square. AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. This is what we got to prove, and we have proved it. And the converse of this is, the converse of Pythagoras theorem is, if in any triangle, the sum of the squares on two sides is equal to the square on the third side, then that is a right angle triangle. That is what we call the converse of Pythagoras theorem. I hope you have understood this. Here some mistake was there. I have corrected it. This is how it is to be proved.